This evening is a very special evening because it's the longest day of the year. I don't know if any of you noticed, but I mean, I woke up 2:30 last night and it was like it could be daytime. So much light there is in Denmark, at least, and we are not the most northern country, but it is kind of a lot of light these days. What is happening when there's a lot of light is that all is exaggerated, you know, it's all getting visual. So, and it's also the last day in the twin today. So, it means that this last month has been like everything is growing and expanding, and the same things are the moods. So you can be all exaggerated happy or exaggerated sad. So if you was very, very sad today, so tomorrow it maybe will be a little bit less because the light will be starting to move back. They say, people say, or the clever people that's writing about the month, that it's written about it that this month is, you have to be careful to take big decisions because there's so much light, there's so much energy that you can get too confident and you can maybe overdo things. Anyway, there's one very, very positive thing about a lot of light is that we get a lot of energy. And what I would like to do tonight is that to make a meditation, a light kind of a travel, where we will, like we did in the last webinar, we will move up through the grail. I just have to find where it is. Not here, not here, not here. Very, not very good. Gone. It's here. We have the earth inside. Now we just take it out for not to make too much noise. So we are going to go, we're going to center us with singing. And we will sing ah, but we will not sing very loud this day. We will sing weak and make it like we get the soft part of us in order not to push the exaggeration too much and go into the heart and just sing ourselves into oneness. And when we are in oneness, we will raise up through the stem of the grail and we will come up in the grail, which I call a kind of a foreyard to heaven. And in this foreyard, we will not, like we did last time, go and ask for our problems and get help or meet some souls up there. No, sorry, coming animals inside. We will find a big, big cone. It's a pineal cone that we will clean together. It's like the pineal cone of all humanity. So in order to raise the awareness or consciousness of humanity, which might be the challenge of these days, that we have to do, that we're forced to do it, and that's very good. So we'll do it together with a hong sound. Each one of us will take a small part and we will purify it. And then after we will go inside it, and then we will take a journey up through the spiraling silver thread that's going from the pineal up and out into the universe. So if you sit and think, this is too much for me, I am not grounded enough for that. I believe you can do it because we're singing some part of this, but we are not singing when we meditate in the and we are out in the universe. If you feel not grounded enough, so be aware that if it's too much for you, get out of it here. It's very important that you keep your feet on the ground, and barefoot is the best because we're going to get a lot of energy through us. So I did the journey in the night here when I couldn't sleep, so it was amazing. So when we're going out in the universe, we will go out through the ether and then we will start to feel we're floating around. And then we will ask to come to a certain planet. We cannot know which one it is, but another planet than an Earth, but a place where they know how to help us and to support Earth and our problems on Earth now. And then we will go there and things will happen, and then we will come back and we will drink our water. You should have water for drinking if you're thirsty, but we have some water that we're going to bless on this place when we come out in the universe, and to restructure it that it will be the purest, finest water you can get. Anyway, it doesn't matter what kind of water you have. Of course, it should be pure, but not very special. It will be special from the singing and from the energy work we do. So, yes, are you ready? I hope so. And we are going to start in a moment. I just have some practical things I will tell you before, because in the end, I think we will have a lot of energy and might be that I forget to tell you this. It is that, I just have to remember it. Yeah, my new book is finished. The Heal the Pineal is finished. It's been really 2.5 hard work. And I'm so happy for Ingeborg Lykke Mitchell. She's a very good graphic designer, and we have been working closely together. She has not a big ego, so you know, we're finding out how to do it together. I really appreciate that. I'm a very creative woman. So I'm very happy for the front page also. And it's going to come in 2-3 days. We've decided to publish it ourselves because it needs to get out now. If it would get out in another bigger publisher than we have here, it would take at least 1 year. And I didn't make really a plan of how the press should be done, you know? That's usually, you can have half a year plan in about that. But it seemed like I have a good idea. And that is, the coming webinars I'm going to do is going to be in a better sound quality than this one. We bought really expensive sound system now, and it's going to get up in 1 or 2 weeks. And then I should be able to do sound healing on the screen without too many strange sounds coming. And I'm going to do different subjects so that if you will have any suggestions about subjects, will you please write it too? I will show you this in the end also, but, oh no, can you see it? Else Marie Dam, elsemarie.dam, this one, snabela, strudel, whatever, @gmail.com. But I'll show you to it in the end, because she will collect them and we'll see what is people need the most. I can also do so. I will also do the one with the Sarega, how we learn how to sing around in that. I do in tinnitus, hearing problems, all kinds of things. And then it will still going to be for free for people that don't have money, but you can donate if you want, because we need to somehow live and also pay for this equipment. But you can also do something else if you don't have money and you like to do something instead of paying a little bit, or you can also just watch for free if that's your what will. But then, if you want to help me, for example, to send press material from this book, if you find it's a nice book, you can do that, and to send it to very nice magazines in your country, because I don't know which magazines are the right one to send to in your country. So maybe you know. And we will send it to you and you just pass it on. That could be a way to do it. So I think that's a genius way because it's sharing. Good. We start. So first of all, would you like to raise your awareness? Would you like that? Then light your candle. If you didn't already do it, we are lighting it up because we say, yes, I would like to raise my awareness and to serve the earth to become a better place, whatever that means for each of us. But awareness is very good for us. So I'm going to light this candle over here. And another thing is that you need to have some water in front of you or close to you. I have a full one here. And to sing for it and to bless it during our trip here. So breathe deeply into your stomach, feet in the ground. And if you sit on the floor, that's also fine. Just that you have the root chakra in the ground. If you have tight clothes, please open it, that your stomach can breathe freely. Breathe in, big stomach. Exhale, push the stomach inside. And why I breathe in through the nose is because it's somehow giving you hot air inside, and also it's getting like, it's easier to get it deep. And when you breathe through the nose, you also stimulate your brain. Actually, it's clever. If something smells not good, that you do it through the mouth, because then it's not going straight to the nervous system, the bad smells. And for each exhalation, just put your hand on the stomach. Be aware that it's going in when you exhale. That's the most important, because then you have grounding. But while we're breathing like this, open up more and more. Open up for the light. All this light that's around you. And you can do any deep sound. Maybe the body wants something. If you're very sad, you might start to cry, then sing on the cry. If you're very happy, you might be getting more quiet now. You can slide also with your voice. And if it's pain to open the mouth, then you can massage your cheeks a little bit. It's very good. I hear all the face to do this. So slowly, slowly we come to sing. And you can sing in three notes, or whatever, actually, whatever note, but this is an A. I give you three notes and then you find one that fits you best, but most women will fit with the A. And you sing softly and try to get into the heart. And remember the stomach. You have to sing from your stomach. It's the stomach sound coming on, the soft stomach going into the heart. And maybe you can feel a little bit close in the back, then open even more than you think you can. We are going to sing like 7 minutes more like this. And even open the mouth more than you think you should do. The tongue relaxed in the mouth. And then you can center the note in the third eye. It's the center of the circle. The note is the circle. And the center is here. And that's an NG sound that's coming in there. Just to a little bit in G. And you can also say And imagine that when you open your mouth, you're actually eating light. You are attracting photons from the etheric field, and it's activated when it's coming into a system. And if the sound of your voice sounds strange and strange sound will come out, it's fine, let it be, because it's your body that is purifying itself. Just continue singing even while I'm talking. When you open yourself like this, the cells will open too. Take some time before you get there. I can hear in my voice that I've been working really hard, so it's still complaining a little bit, my voice, but I'll come back to status quo after some days, I think. And you can put your head a little bit back, not to lock your neck, but a little bit back, and if you are very good in the breathing, you can put your arms out, fully out with the open palms up towards the light, the sky. And you can put a little bit more power now. It's actually easier when you put power. Ah. successful 7 minutes. I'm going to start our journey now. So, bless the water. You have energy in your hands now, we bless the water. Feel some energy in your hands. I think most people do that, and you just bless the water. This is also the water you drink. It will get soft and tasty. Now, we are going into the center of this foot of the rail. We came from here, we moved in towards the center. And now we will raise up through the stem, all the way up, and into the grain. If you feel you cannot get up, then make yourself small, like a tadpole, or small insect, small fish, you can get up there. And you can always get down again. This is what we practice, to move back and forwards from earth and up to the foyer to heaven. That's very good to be able to do that, because you can always seek help here. So now, I think we're all up now, and we are surrounding now a huge cone, very, very, very big, beautiful cone, and it's actually silvery and golden under. It's a crystal with a lot of gold and silver and light shining into it, but the problem is that it's having a lot of choke on it. It's choked from fluoride, chloride, chlorine, and calcium. And it could also be aluminium, is also one of the things sitting there. From the purification of our drinking water, I mean, that's what some places they put this in drinking water, and will disturb our chemistry in the brain like that. So now we will do the sound ha, ha, ha. The ha is just lifting the sound, and then the ng, ha. And we are going to, like this, we can shiver the pineal. When we do this big huge pineal gland and we purify it, we will actually also do our own. So now we just do it together. Are you ready? Go for it. And you can climb up in the top, you can be everywhere. We are working on this now together. The world's consciousness, we are going to purify it. Should we say 3 minutes? Oh. There's a lot of dirt on it, huh? But there were some very nice places. Now I saw some of you polished it and it got really turquoise and pink light inside. So it's cleared some part of it now. And this, you can do more. I will share this meditation on YouTube and our page, our cosmoporter.com. So you can do it again. Even if it's not midsummer anyway, but we can use this meditation anyway. Now, please, you go inside the grail. The grail can go from inside, there's under it, there's an opening, and you go into it. You can also imagine that, just to think about that, this huge pine cone is also a part of the Vatican's symbol. They have a huge one outside, so it's not coming from nothing, this. So we're going inside it. It's a room inside it, very beautiful, full of crystals. And we go inside, and up in the top there's a hole and there's a string, and the silver thread is just climbing up here, all the way up. And then we're going to leave up in out into the universe. You have this string with you all the time. So whenever you want to come back, you will go back this way. And if you're afraid that you will lose the contact, I will bring it down. Going up now. Feel how you're going up, spiraling up. And even you can't see or feel the thread, it's with you because you're a soul and you have this string with you all the time. I'm holding all these strings in my hands. Thank you, God. Let me hold them. Thank you. Going out, out, out. Until you reach the ether and boom. Weight. You have no weight. Floating. Now ask to be leaded to the planet, not planet Earth, but a planet where there are souls or human-like beings that you or we can communicate with. Souls that are more clever than we are, more wise, and that know how to help us to raise consciousness on Earth, so that we can make this very important shift that is happening right now from the money society to a new oneness thinking. So you will be led to the place. We're traveling quite fast now, but you don't feel it because you're out in space. So now we are coming closer to the planet, and they're waiting for us there. It's kind of crystal beings somehow, and they tell us that it's really important what we're doing right now, because they cannot help us unless we ask for help. Do you want help? They ask us. Say, yes, we need help. So which kind of help do you need? We would like to raise love, gratitude and compassion on Earth. We would like to raise the consciousness that we can live in balance with the universe also in Earth. So what they tell us is, we will restructure your water. You are pure water. All your organism is water. 99.9% is water, because the water inside your cells is the fourth phase of water, gel. And we will now restructure it so that you will be purified. Do you want us to do that? Is that fine? Yes, I would like to do it. If you don't want, you say no. You will do it, and you will have no problems with it, because the way we do it is in a way that the toxins will be, they will be so fine powder that it's very easy to excrete it out. Very good. We thank you. So they now heal you. They balance you. And they give you the love that you've missed. Fill out all empty places so that you can be a balanced being when you return to Earth. Their message is that when we return to Earth, we will spread love, light, compassion, gratitude, and we also will spread the structured water that we will bring in our body. Because when we touch water from now, it will be structured just by us touching it. Our pee will be structured, and when the structured water come into contact with other waters, these water would love and be attracted to that, and it will spread like fire, the structured water. So everyone should be finished being healed, Some people have some more toxin, they must work a little bit harder on you. It's very important you drink water the next 2 days or 3 days to purify the toxins. So now a cat came in, very, very purring. We are ready to come back. Just finish the last healing. Yes, there's one left. Thank you very much, they're finished now. We seal the energy by holding our hands in the breast, in the heart chakra, thanking for the energy, for the healing we got. Thank you to the planet. I get some kind of name, but I'm not sure about it. We will see. It's not important, they say, which name it is. We will find you whenever you need help, they say. You have connected now and we will find you. Thank you. We are now traveling back. I just ask to come back to Earth and you will come back to Earth. Floating among the stars. You're a star yourself. You're all energy, full of light. Now we're coming down to the ether soon. And then you must be ready when you go through the ether. You'll get more heavy after. Just, it's a different feeling. We reach the ether now, boom, and then there's another feeling in the body. We're coming to the foreyard of heaven, back, spiraling back into the pineal, and from inside we will heal the pineal by holding our hands, restructure it so that it will be full of energy. Your energy to the pineal from inside. Start to sparkle, and all of us get a lot of energy because the pineal now start to pull in energy from the sun, and now we get the healing also from the pineal. We get electricity into our body. So now you're uploaded and the cat like it too, purring, purring. It's kind of nice to stand in here. Oh my God, a lot of energy. So you should know you can go here whenever you need some energy. You can just travel up to the foreyard of heaven and enter the collective pineal gland. Inside it is a wonderful room. You can also take a bath in crystal water. So now we are continuing back to Earth and coming down. And if it's hard to come down, make yourself a little bit more heavy maybe. and just take some lead things in your hands. If it's hard to come down, because the body, actually the soul likes to stay up. So, yes, now we're coming down, standing on the feet, sitting on the chair with our feet on the ground. And while we wait for everybody to land, you can take the water and bless it. Gratitude, compassion, love, healing. Have it in your hands now, in your all your body. Think the loved one is coming down now. Yes, very good. And now we take a glass of water. And dip the third eye and let it enter inside the ear, inside the pituitary, go on into the beak of the inner bird's head, which is the hypothalamus, and all the way to the back of the bird's head that is in the center of your brain, where the pineal gland is. So we just enter the water here. Thank you, pineal gland. Would you please, dear pineal gland, communicate with the big mother or father pineal gland in the foyer of here. And now we drink small sips. Thank you. And in the end here, we will sing a song, and my son is coming in now. It is Yevarechecha Adonai. We have singing it in the old mixture of old Hebrew and Aramaic because it's a holy language. So some people say it must have come from the universe somewhere, because there's so many layers in that language. Same thing with the there are also other languages like this, but few. And here now my son is coming. Come in.
Hello.
And this fellow, Ben-David. Yes, he's coming out from space. So. I just want to tell, and that's my husband's book, The God Formula. It's a very nice book. And it's written here, because I don't remember it in all languages. I can tell you in Danish, it's Herren velsigne og bevare dig. Herren lad sit ansigt lyse over dig og give dig fred. And in English, it is the Lord, may the Lord bless you and keep you. It's for protection. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. That's a consciousness. The Lord turn his face towards you. And that's the light, the sun, the Lord, it's the energy. And give you peace, healing. So, Yevarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha is the first line. Ya'er Yehovah panav elecha v'yechonecha. It's the second line, the consciousness, and the third line, Yishar Yehovah Panav Elecha. And the last line is Ve'yashim Lecha Shalom, and we'll give you peace. Yeah. You start, Pelle will start with a little bit improvisation. Come on, Pelle. Come more into it. Okay, I will not play that. I'll play another instrument. Yeah. Together. We are one. We are not alone here, even if it can feel like we're alone. So thank you. Bye.